Welcome back to my channel. Today I have an exciting video for you guys because it is another Amazon video, your favorite. So I've accumulated another long list of things that I have purchased from Amazon. So I wanted to sit down and share all of the new-ish items with you guys or just any items that I haven't shared before. Keep in mind that I do make a lot of Amazon videos. So some people get frustrated in the comments saying, how can you include that in a must-haves if you've just gotten it? Okay, I just title my videos Amazon must-haves because that is what I am kind of known for, or that is what I do often. So if you want frequent Amazon videos, I'm gonna have to, you know, talk about them only a week or two after I got them sometimes. Like, that's just how this works. But I'm sharing things with you, letting you know my true thoughts, if I have tried it, if I haven't tried it. Sometimes I do updates on certain things that I've tried on my Instagram. So if you're not following me on there, I definitely recommend doing so. Also, I wanted to let you guys know that I actually created an Amazon storefront. So many of you in all of my Amazon videos comment and say, girlfriend, why don't you have an Amazon storefront? You have so many Amazon videos. Why is it not organized in an Amazon storefront? And honestly, it takes a lot of time and I'm not someone to do something half-assed. If I was gonna do a storefront, I wanted every single item that I've purchased that I would recommend on the storefront. So I literally took the time one day and went back to 2017, 2016 purchases, and everything that I liked that I bought from Amazon, I added to my storefront. It's categorized home stuff, fashion, beauty, fitness, like everything is categorized. So I'm super excited about it. I will link it down below. I know a lot of you guys have been asking me about that for a long time. So it'll take you a little while to browse through it because there is a lot of stuff, but it's all really good stuff, guys. So anyways, with that being said, let's get into the video. First, I will start with an organizational item, and that is this little pink bin right here. So this is a 3-compartment sort of container bin, whatever you want to call it. It is like a hard plastic. It is by the brand M Design, I want to say, which I get a lot of my organizational items from on Amazon. I loved the pink color of this one. It's super, super affordable. I just keep this right up against the wall on my bathroom counter, like in my master bathroom. And it holds things that I need to use every single day. So deodorant, contact solution, toothpaste, and my hair oil. And then I have like a leave-in treatment after the shower and the same thing over here. I know some people hate this. Some people don't like having anything on their counters at all. But for me, that's just the most functional. If you're like me and you want things like sitting out because you pick them up every single day, try something like this where it looks a little cuter. It's in a little pink bin, but it's still organized and easy to access. And I think they do have a few other colors as well if you are not a pink person. I always say that in all of my videos. I like pink. I get a lot of things in pink. If you don't, check and see if there's other colors. That's all I can say. Next up is a cute little beauty item, and that is not the lipsticks themselves or the organizer, even though I could link an organizer if you guys are interested, just because this one I got years and years ago, but I'm sure they have some on Amazon just like it. But what I wanted to talk about is the clear caps that I have on my MAC lipsticks right here. Someone else recommended this, like a blogger or something, and I thought it was the cutest idea because for the longest time I have stored my MAC lipsticks in this container right here, which is a little dusty. I need to dust that. I thought this would just be a really fun way to switch it up, and then I can actually see what color each lipstick is. I don't have to, usually I would have to like pick them all up and be like, okay, which one is that? So I know what color it is. But now I can just see the color through the clear caps. And I have a lot of other like acrylic or clear containers for organization in my studio room. So it kind of just went with my aesthetic as well, aside from the like functionality of being able to see the color of the lipstick. I also just thought they were super cute. I want to say it came with 12 clear caps, and I think that you can get them for other brands of lipstick as well, not just MAC lipsticks. Next up, a couple of productivity things, and these are like notepads that you can use to plan your week or your day or make a to-do list. So first up is this one that I got to plan your day. So it has a lot of different sections. As you can see, I started filling this one out, but it has today I'm grateful for, if you had to go to appointments, which right now I think none of us are going to appointments, but yeah, you could have a slot for appointments, your to-do list, must get done today, so like your top 3 priority, notes and doodles, your meal planning right down here, and then your health and fitness, water intake, and today's achievements. So really, really cute little notepad here. And then this one is a weekly sort of planner. They both just say like, you've got this at the top, really cute pink aesthetic. This one just has like Monday through Sunday, a like to-do list for each day. So I've obviously been utilizing this one each week, and then it has a section for notes and doodles and weekly goals, a next week to-do list, and then your just like weekly to-do list. So I really love those, and I ordered another one that is a weekly view. I'll insert a picture right here, but it has like a habit tracker on it and then the day-to-day to-do list still, but a little smaller. And then the other one I wanted to show you guys is this one that says the Get Shit Done list. Unfortunately, mine looks a little disheveled because when my puppy, who is like 7 months old right now, when he was probably 4 months old, he got this off of our kitchen table and chewed it up. So I had to rip off quite a few pages. Not looking great, but you know, it's fine. Anyways, super cute. I use this just like for a daily to-do list if I just want to like jot things down really quickly, or if I have a project I'm working on, just like what steps I need to get done for that, whatever it might be. I just wanted something for like a quick little to-do list. So yeah, I utilize these little notepads more than you would even imagine. Like, they are just so helpful, so I highly recommend those. All right, let's talk a few kitchen things. I love buying things from Amazon for my kitchen, and recently I've really been into getting like some organizational pieces, and I have a crap ton of water bottles at my house. I don't know about you guys, but I'm a water bottle addict, but I wanted a way to organize my water bottles inside my cabinet. So I found a water bottle organizer that I love, and I think this is also by M Design. I'll insert a clip of what mine actually looks like now that it's in my cabinet, but I do have an extra piece that I'll share with you right now. So it looks like this. It just has like three sections for three different water bottles, and it comes in, well, I got mine in a 2-pack. I think you can also get a 4-pack maybe. But anyways, you stack them on top of each other, and then your water bottles just go in just like that, and it fits right inside my cabinet. It is perfect. It saves us so much room because you can't really stack water bottles like that. But laying them down like this in an organizer just saves us so much space vertically. So that has been really awesome. I'm super happy I got this. My husband was very happy that I got this. He's like, he really supported this Amazon purchase because it helped us organize our cabinets a little bit better. Okay, sticking with the kitchen theme really quick, I have a few more items. So next is our food scale, which is a little dirty with fingerprints and things, but you get the point. So we just have this stainless steel little food scale. I got this when I started doing like Weight Watchers and all of that. Just like try and eat healthier, I would actually weigh out my food sometimes just to like know how many points things were, how many calories sometimes. So yeah, I always recommend having a food scale. It's just one of those kitchen essentials that like you don't need it often, but when you do, you really, really want it. It has multiple different units, grams, milliliters, fluid ounces, pounds, of course, whatever. And then you can like say if you wanted to sit a bowl on it, you could sit the bowl and then zero it out and then add berries to the bowl and see exactly how many grams of berries you are eating. We liked this one because it was stainless steel and matches all of our other appliances and everything. I've had some other like plastic food scales and I didn't like them as much. This one just seems like more sturdy and just a lot better quality than the other ones that I've had in the past. So if you are looking for a new food scale, then I definitely recommend this one. I've had this for a while, so tried and true. These we just picked up because, again, our same puppy also got one of our kitchen mitts off of the counter and chewed it up too, so I had to get new kitchen mitts. We really like the miniature ones. They just fit in our drawers a lot better, and they're like just the same as the like huge ones that go all the way down your wrist. They're just like beige. They match our kitchen. They have like a grip sort of thing on the finger part. I haven't used them too much yet, but my husband said that these don't contain heat like our other ones do, which we got at TJ Maxx. So anyways, just to each their own, but if you just want some miniature little oven mitts, these are pretty good. I mean, I haven't like been burned. You're not gonna burn yourself. I think he's just saying our other ones were a little bit thicker, but yeah, they have a lot of different colors. They just stack easily in our drawers and they're very easy to store. The next kitchen thing I wanted to talk about is a set of chip clips, and I wanted chip clips for a lot of different things like popcorn, chips, dog food, like bread, anything like that, flour that you wanted to just secure closed. So I found this little set. It actually comes with a lot more than this. I'll insert a picture right here, but it comes with one of the really big ones. So right now I just have it on a little bag of Safe and Fair popcorn, which is so yummy. They also came with a bunch of these little guys, which is really all you need for a chip bag. I just have the big one on this for I don't really know why. And they actually have magnets on the back as well in case you did want to use them to clip something on your fridge or whatever. And then it came with a few of these little guys as well. And these guys are mostly for like if you twist a, say a loaf of bread and you twist it up and then you put the little piece in there and it just secures it closed like that. Or powdered sugar, you could twist something like that and put this on it. It'll keep it secure. So that's what we've been using these for. When I bought the pack, I was like, what are those things and how do you use them? Why do you need them? But I will say they have been so handy. I did not ever know this thing existed. We have been using those like nonstop as soon as we got them. And then the last kitchen thing that I wanted to talk about, I think, is a little recipe book right here. So this is the My Favorite Recipes journal. And I got this because everyone, I feel like nowadays, finds recipes online, on Pinterest, or cooking blogs, like whatever it might be. All of our recipes are found online. I mean, you can save them on your laptop, but it's still, I don't know about you guys, I have some saved on Pinterest, some saved to my bookmarks. They're all over the place, and I always like go to find a recipe. Say, for instance, I made a sweet potato casserole for my family's Thanksgiving, and then I made it again some other time, and I could not find the recipe. I was like, is it on Pinterest? Is it on this? I can't find it. So that's when I ordered this book, because I wanted to be able to save the favorite recipes that I've had from online and write them down and have them all in one book. This is what a blank page looks like in the book. So you just list your ingredients right here, your directions. It has a rating, difficulty level, serving number, cooking time, best served with like a drink, wine, whatever, and then notes right here. You can also do a table of contents. So say you do have 45 recipes, you can just have a little table of contents. Again, makes it easy for your husband or anyone else who might need to look through the recipe book. I had saw someone else recommend one of these that was like a hardcover and it was really cute. It was like spiral bound, super cute, but it was like $50. And I was like, whoa, I don't need to spend $50 on a recipe journal. I'm not that serious. So I found this one for much, much, much cheaper. Okay, switching gears, I wanted to talk to you guys about something that I don't have like to physically hold up for you guys, but that is a clear desk cover that I purchased from Amazon that I am obsessed with. It was a lifesaver. So if you don't know, in my like studio room that I film in right here, like right in front of me, I have a desk system that I kind of created from IKEA. So I got two of the smaller Alex drawers from IKEA. They're the Alex 5 drawers. So I got two of those. And then me and my husband went and got a matching piece of wood that fit over top of them that was like long enough and wide enough. And we sat that on top because they don't sell a desk from IKEA with the two Alex 5 drawers on the end, which is just mind-blowing to me because so many people want that and so many people recreate it on their own, so I just don't get why they wouldn't sell it. So we got the piece of wood from Lowe's, sanded it, painted it white to match the Alex drawers, and it was great literally for maybe 2 weeks, and then I do my makeup on that desk, so the wood just gets so like dirty and grimy and it's hard to clean wood. So anyways, I was like, you know what, a good solution to this would just be to get a clear mat to put over it that I can easily wipe down. It's so easy to clean. I'm not worried about if I spill foundation on it or whatever it might be. I can just get a makeup wipe and wipe it right off. So that is what I did. I found one that pretty much fits perfectly. I mean, it's like literally like an inch too big, but it doesn't bother me at all. If you have any tables in your house that you don't want to get dirty or ruined, if you have kids, a lot of people use these for like their dining room tables or anything like that. And it comes in a bunch of different sizes, so you can definitely find one that fits your need. Another thing that I use in my studio quite often is a step stool. I have a very tall closet system from IKEA right over here, and I have to use a step stool sometimes to be able to reach my like highest level. So I ordered this one because we have one already, but it doesn't fold up and it's really cute, but we use it in the kitchen a lot. I just wanted to get another one for in here, and I got this one that folds up. So this is a 13 inch, I believe. It's just in a white color. You can get any color that you really want. So you just fold it up like this, reach up on the handlebars and it just folds so you can easily store it, which is perfect for what I needed in here because I want to be able to store it nicely. I don't want it to be like an eyesore, but I also definitely need it in here for functionality of my closet. All right, my hair is getting progressively worse. Like, what is happening over here? Next up, let's talk about some fashion things that I've recently picked up. The first is a pair of shoes. I talked about these over on my Instagram, but I wanted to mention them here as well because they are super freaking cute. These are just like a clear sandal with the gold studs and pearls on the straps. Super, super cute shoe. I love the clear like jelly sandal. It's really in style. I never thought it would be. I wore this style of shoe when I was literally like 6 years old, but now the jelly style is back. So I'm not sure how or why, but whatever. I liked the clear ones and these are just like a slip-on version. But if you go to the link that I list in the description, there's also a bunch of different styles of these in black, nude, with like gold studs. There's ones with a bow that I actually have as well from a long time ago that kind of look like the Valentino sandals. There's a bunch of different options. I chose the clear, like I said, because I don't have anything like this already. And I liked the slip-on sort of design rather than like the buckle design. Next, I recently picked up a bathing suit, which I obviously have not gotten to wear yet because of everything going on, but I wanted to share it with you guys anyways in case you wanted to pick it up for any future vacations or whatever. So it's just a black bikini set. So it comes with bottoms that look like this. They are high-waisted and they are a little bit cheeky, but not too much. So I like that. And I like how the band here isn't too thick either. So it still looks like pretty modern. And then the top just looks like this. It's just a really simple top that has two little skinny straps right there and it hooks in the back. It does make me a little concerned that this wouldn't stay. It's just like a little buckle and sometimes it doesn't stay. Anyways, so we'll have to test this out maybe at my parents' lake house or something before I wear it like out on the beach. I always like a good simple black bathing suit in the summertime. Next, I picked up this little coin purse right here that is kind of like a Gucci inspired coin purse. At least that's the vibe I got just because of the little bumblebee and the pink color and little tassel. So I thought this was absolutely adorable. It actually came in a 2-pack. I don't think I really need to, but I can give one to a friend or my mom or whatever, or save it for a future giveaway. If you wanted to attach it to your keys or something like that, you totally could. But I love little pouches like this. I keep like my credit cards or gift cards in these. If I just wanted to like grab a little coin purse and my keys and go, I totally could. So yeah, super, super cute. And I loved that they were kind of like Gucci inspired. I don't know. Do you guys get that vibe? And it's like a really soft, I mean, I know it's not real leather, but it's like a really soft faux leather. To me, it looks like very expensive and chic. I'm just really happy with this purchase. And you get two of them for a pretty good price. I also picked up an Adidas hat on Amazon recently. I have been so into hats lately during quarantine because I don't feel like doing my hair. And if I just like want to feel put together and just like, you know, get it out of my face, then I will put on a hat. And they had a bunch of different colors and I really couldn't decide because I'd already bought a lot of other hats during quarantine. So I didn't really want to get one that was super similar to something I already had. So I decided on this one that kind of looks like a jean, like acid wash sort of material. I don't have anything like this, but yet I feel like it would go with a lot of like different outfits because in my opinion, denim goes with pretty much everything. I've been wearing this quite a bit lately. I'm not gonna put it all the way on, even though I should because my stupid hair, maybe I will, gosh. My hair is being crazy in this video. Should I wear it the whole rest of the video? Point is, I've been loving hats lately in quarantine, so this one was a must-have. Okay, another fashion piece that I recently got from Amazon is this belt right here. I really like this belt. I saw it on a couple of other bloggers, but I haven't gotten a chance to actually like style it and wear it out, obviously. But yeah, it's pretty much just like a woven little belt like this, and it has a really big square piece in the middle. So it's definitely a statement belt, but I think with the right dress, this could just like completely change your outfit and make it so cute. They had a bunch of different styles and colors of this as well. This is like really trendy right now. I don't know why, just dressing things up with like a big statement belt. A lot of girls have even been putting them on like swimsuits and stuff, which I don't know if I would have the nerve to do that, but with like a cute little white sundress, this would be really cute. Okay, next I want to talk about some office items that I have picked up from Amazon that I'm not able to actually physically show you because they are at my office, which I cannot go to because COVID-19. But I did take videos last time I was there to pick up some stuff that I needed before I had to work from home. I took clips because I knew I was gonna film this video of those items. So I will show the clips and talk about them right now. We recently moved offices like right before this whole pandemic. So I purchased a few things for my office that all kind of matched. So you guys know I love gold. So I went with like the gold theme. So I got a gold and acrylic tape dispenser. I actually haven't ordered tape for it yet. So I need to order tape. But the actual tape dispenser itself was so cute. I love it. It just looks really chic. It's really thin. It doesn't take up a lot of space on your desk. I also got a gold and white stapler. It's not just like a cheap gold stapler. No offense to Target, but I went in Target and they had like a bunch of these gold staplers on sale, but I like literally tried to use each one of them and they had staples in it. I checked and like they were all broken. So I'm like, no wonder it's on clearance. It is not a good product. Sorry, I've been like waving this pen around. I don't know why I've been doing that. I'm sorry. Anyways, I went on Amazon and I found this white and gold stapler from an actual like really good stapler brand, which means it's gonna be good quality work and not something that I'm not even gonna be able to staple like four pages together with. So anyways, I got this one. I like it. I was using it nonstop before I had to work from home. So it is very good quality stapler and it is super cute on my desk. I love it. I also picked up a little pen holder that is gold from Amazon. Really inexpensive, very cute, matches my other stuff, has like three little sections so I can put like scissors, pens, highlighters, all of that stuff in one little compartment. I also picked up a sticky note dispenser, which is so cute. This one's actually rose gold, so it doesn't match my gold stuff, but I still got it because it was cute and whatever. But yeah, you just put a pad of sticky notes inside and then you take one off and it releases another one. And I love just taking notes on my post-it notes now because I can just bam, pop one off, write something down, and I just feel really like professional. And then the last thing that was at my office that I don't have to share with you guys today is two tall file holders. So they're like file organizers, I guess I should say. They're really tall, they're gold, and they have like a space for a label. I'll insert the clip. But yeah, I love those. They're really, really, really good quality. I actually was not expecting them to be as good of quality as they actually were. I use it to store notebooks and like checks and marketing materials for my job. So I just have them on a shelf in my desk. And I just have like our business cards, rack cards, and things like that in one of them, and then my like notebooks for work and another one. So yeah, super cute. They just look adorable on my desk. So I thought I'd mention those. Another thing that I got for work or my office is this little vacuum cleaner. So this is a desktop vacuum cleaner. I really like this for not only my desk at work, but also my laptop. So you just turn it on like this and you just move it around and it picks up like mostly dust and crumbs and small things, of course, but it works really, really well. My husband was actually impressed with this too. I got it out at home once I brought it home and he was like, oh my gosh, that's kind of cool. And then you just take the lid off. Oh, it takes two AA batteries, by the way. That was the wrong compartment. You just push this down and you can empty it. So yeah, you can see what it's picked up. So it obviously doesn't hold very much because it's tiny, but it holds enough. Super cute little miniature vacuum. The smallest vacuum cleaner I have ever seen. Another sort of thing for the office, but sort of just for anyone, is a new pair of blue light glasses that I picked up. This is from the brand TIJN. Came in a little nice pouch right here, but they're just really cute. I'm gonna just look like a crazy person. Now I have a hat on, eyelashes, makeup, glasses. I have it all going on. But these are super cute, very unique. Oh, they're really dusty, I guess because I put them back in that pouch. But I have been wearing these a lot recently. My eyes have been killing me and giving me such bad headaches ever since I've been working from home. I guess just because I'm literally looking all day at my computer for my full-time job and then I go work on YouTube. I swear it, I literally look at my laptop like 18 hours a day, which is so not good. At least when I was out and about, I had the breaks of like driving or going to lunch or whatever, but like when I'm at home, I'm always looking at a screen, my phone, my laptop, TV, whatever. And I've really been trying to not do that as much, like take breaks. But another thing that helps if you do have to be looking at your computer screen or your phone all day is a pair of blue light glasses. They help me tremendously. Black frames, they have the gold detailing in the middle and the gold arms. Not sure, but anyways, I really like these. If you are looking for a new pair of blue light glasses, definitely recommend these. They're really good quality. And they're just cute, make you look studious, and they will help your eyes and your headaches. Another thing I quickly wanted to mention before I forget is the stainless steel dog ball that I use for my golden retriever. I didn't want to get out of his bowl because he just ate in it with it this morning and it's kind of dirty. I need to wash it before I would show it to you guys, but I will film it. Basically, for my golden retriever, he eats so freaking fast. So I wanted to find a solution for him to not eat so fast, but I didn't really want one of those like mats where they like, it's like a maze to eat, because I just honestly didn't want it in my floor and like having to get that out every day. Yeah. So I found this big stainless steel ball that you put down inside of the bowl that they already eat out of, and they just kind of have to like work around it, and it makes him eat 10 times slower. Like, it really helped him, so I don't have to be nervous about him eating too fast. And a lot of golden retrievers have like issues with their stomachs flipping and things if they eat too fast, so I was very nervous and I wanted to find a solution, and this works great. So I get questions about it all the time from people that come over or in my videos if you see it. But yeah, that is what the stainless steel dog ball is for in his dog bowl, is to help him eat slower. Next up, a couple of like spa-ish or beauty related things. First, I've talked about these before, but I wanted to mention them again because I did buy two more of them because I really, really like them. These are just like facial towels. I got mine in the nude shade, but they have a bunch of other colors. I use like two in my master bathroom for actually cleansing my face and like wiping it down once I cleanse and all of that. But then I use two in here to just wipe off my hands when I'm doing my makeup, or if I like get too much lipstick, like I don't know, I'll just use these for whatever I need while doing my makeup. Throw them in the wash once a week or every few days, however often you use them. And yeah, you're good to go. So they have them in packs of like six or packs of two. Definitely recommend these little towels if you're looking for something like that. That's just like, I don't know, a little smoother and softer than a washcloth. Another sort of face cloth that I recently picked up, I saw these when I was looking for those and I decided to give them a shot. I've only used it once, but they're pretty much just these little funky looking face towels that look like a face mask. So they have like a slot for your eyes and your nose so you can breathe and everything. Basically, you can either get these hot or cold, and it's kind of like a spa night, which I think we all could agree that we need right now. So I have a skincare fridge, so I like putting it in cold water and then putting it in my fridge for 10 minutes and doing that in the morning to kind of like wake me up. I like cold in the morning, and then at night sometimes I will just soak them in hot water and do like a little hot steam mask sort of thing. So I really, really like these. Do you need them to like have the holes and stuff for your face? Not necessarily, but it is like, I don't know, kind of more of like a relaxing spa sort of feel. And then these are like a lot thicker than any washcloths I own, so that also helps too, to kind of just feel more plush and, I don't know, helps me feel more relaxed. It's kind of like weighted on my face. And then the last sort of beauty thing that I wanted to talk about is a pack of two hair towels that I picked up. I love putting my hair in a hair towel or like a turby sort of twist when I get out of the shower. It's kind of like the only thing that I can wrap around my hair. It'll stay there and it'll soak up all the water until I'm ready to dry my hair. And they're really cute. It comes with a pink one and a cream one. And they're like this, I don't know, this like kind of weird material, but I love it. It's like fuzzy sort of material, very soft, very absorbent, and they have just like a little button right here. I don't know if you guys have ever used one of these, but they're like the perfect shape. So you flip your hair over, twist it, and then take this part around like this sort of, and then it buttons right here. So you just attach it and your hair stays nice and secure until you are ready to blow dry. Very functional and useful for me. And they come in this little package right here too. So Again, cute packaging always helps. All right, only a couple more things. First up is this little pink silicone mat that I purchased for my vanity. Because I got that clear mat on my desk that I was telling you guys about, I didn't want the hot tools to burn that at all or melt it. So I wanted to get a little silicone mat to kind of protect that. So yeah, I just lay this right next to where I do my hair, and my hot tools lay on it perfectly fine. And I don't have to worry about it burning my, in my case, the clear mat on my desk. But if you also have like a countertop or just anything like that, you don't want to worry about it burning the surface underneath, then these are always a really good idea. They have multiple different colors, and I like the ridges in them too because it helps my hot tools stay upright. Not much to say about it, but it's really good quality, very thick, and just overall a great product. And then the last thing that I was going to talk to you guys about is a product called Sweet Sweat. I don't know if you guys have heard of this before, but I started using this a long time ago, months and months and months, almost a year, I want to say probably 9 months before my wedding. They have a bunch of different products that they sell, but I'm just going to obviously be telling you about the ones that I purchased. So first is the Sweet Sweat Waist Trainer. Or trimmer, I guess is actually what it's called. So basically what you do, I saw multiple different reviews on this. I contemplated it for a while because I'm usually not the type to like go into these like gimmicky, like, oh, it makes your waist smaller, blah, 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 whatever. But it had literally like 5-star review, thousands of reviews. Basically what you do is you get the Sweet Sweat. You don't have to get the Sweet Sweat product, but it's kind of the intent to it. So this is the workout enhancer. You take this off and it's kind of like a gel or something. You screw it up and you just put this like all over your stomach or wherever you are putting a Sweet Sweat band. Because they also have armbands, which I purchased as well. I think it came in like a pack or something, which is why I got both. But yeah, these are for your arms. So you just put them like on your biceps or something like that. Anywhere where you want to sweat more, they have a lot of different products. I think they have them for your legs. Anywhere where you feel like you hold excess weight, because all of our bodies are different. Some people gain weight evenly on your body. Some people gain it mostly in their stomach. Some people mostly gain it in their legs. Some people mostly gain it in their arms. So I think that's like the kind of point of it. It's not going to make you magically skinny. It's not going to make you have a snatched waist. It's just anywhere where you want to sweat more because you feel like your body holds fat there more, this is a good product for that. So it's not a waist trainer. It's not like the Kim Kardashian thing where it like sucks you in and you can't breathe. Not like that at all. Basically what these do is this product makes you sweat more in that area. In my case, I have the arms and the waist one. So I would just put it on my arms or put it on my stomach and then wrap my waist trimmer around, work out with this on. And when you take it off, the amount of sweat that is underneath this band is insane and disgusting all at the same time. The first time I used this and the amount of sweat that I saw underneath, and trust me, a lot of people are like, that's just because it's like trapping your sweat and you can't see it. You sweat the same amount. No freaking way. You can ask my husband. I showed him the first time I used this. And he knows I don't sweat very much when I work out in that area. Like I sweat on my back and like in weird places, but I don't sweat where I want to sweat, you know? So the first time I used it and I showed him, he was like, holy crap. Like I don't sweat like that on my stomach or on my arms. So it really does work. And I do enjoy using them as long as you are comfortable wearing something a little bulky. Anyways, I feel like I've rambled about this, but it's a pretty good product. It basically just makes you sweat more. And the idea is to, if you sweat more in an area, then you'll lose weight first in that area. So that's the kind of idea about it. I'm not saying it made me lose any more weight than I normally would have, but I felt like it definitely made me sweat more in the areas that I was trying to lose more fat. I don't wear both at the same time, by the way. I usually do one or the other. I don't want to be like, so I don't know, bulky. Anyways, I think that is all that I have to share with you guys today. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video and found some items that you are interested in checking out on Amazon. Also, don't forget to like this video, subscribe if you are not already, and check out my Amazon storefront that I recently created. You guys are gonna love it. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will talk to you all very soon in my next video. Bye guys.